should probably just start at the beginning. The name's Sly. Sly Cooper. And I'm a thief. From a long line of thieves. In fact, thieving is the family business. And business was good. Although, until recently, I considered myself retired. Having hung up my mask and cane, I was enjoying life on the other side of the law. In the company of a certain lovely Interpol agent named Carmelita Fox. She and I had a history, which generally involved her trying to lock me up. So, I should mention our current situation was only possible because she thought I had amnesia. I didn't. It was great to finally enjoy each other's company without a shock pistol being involved, and we quickly put the past behind us. But as time went on, the old itch came back, and I knew I needed to pull a heist. I should also mention that as a master thief, I only steal from other thieves. So it took me a while, but I finally found what I was looking for. My target was an upstart art mogul, a real hotshot collector. He seemed respectable, had even opened a new museum. But I could smell a rat. Reliable sources told me he was dealing in black market antiques worth millions. So I felt he should share the wealth. I was working on a plan when one night, as if on cue, Bentley showed up. Bentley was the brains of our operation, the mastermind. We grew up in the same orphanage where we bonded over stealing cookies, our very first heist. And we've been best friends and partners ever since. We hadn't seen each other for a while, but I knew immediately that something was up. Building a new lab from scratch with his girlfriend and fellow tech whiz, Penelope. She had joined the team on her last paper, and the two of them had really hit it off. Apparently, they just finished work on a top-secret project when Penelope had simply vanished. Bentley was worried sick. He searched frantically but found nothing. Then, he noticed something that completely stunned him. In his spare time, Bentley had been researching the Thievius Raccoonus, a master thief's handbook passed down through the Cooper family for generations. Its pages overflowing with the exploits and secret techniques of my esteemed ancestors. Only now, those pages weren't so full. In fact, they were disappearing right before Bentley's eyes. Realizing there was no time to waste, he gathered his gear and raced off to Paris. The first thing Bentley did was track down Murray, the third in our trio. Murray was our enforcer.
What are you waiting?
And the guy who'd eaten all the cookies we stole back in our orphanage.
What? Come here! What the hell?
Years, the three of us have become an unbeatable team.
This is my punch, you!
No! Murray had been living his dream.
What's that person right there for?
Distracted by a new assignment, I took the opportunity to slip away and met up with the guys at our blue from Paris hideout. Travel back in time, stop those responsible, and fix the damage they've done. Bentley explained the only catch was that in order to travel to a particular time, the machine required an object from that era. We knew from the changes to the Thievius Raccoonus that our first stop was feudal Japan. steal a priceless 17th century samurai dagger from the same museum I've been casing. Stop worrying. This is gonna be a piece of cake. I'll see you both inside. Now let's get going.
Good to be back in business.
security of this place. It's better be worth it. Shut down the security system.
Patience, Sly. You can't rush greatness, and I'm about to code a hacking masterpiece. Interesting. The last time I was in these sewers, I was just a teenager. My mom should make short work of that grate. I just need to press the triangle button to place one. That was a blast.
Thank you. security system coming, Bentley.
Great. Perfect. Mm-hmm. I'll be done in a jiffy.
Thank you. can have your corner pistols.
I want to make the whole little birthday card. Where? In a drawer.
Hey. Which one? The bottom one or?
Funny meeting you here.
You no good lying thief. I'm making you up for good.
Sorry, gotta take a rain check.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Trip door so I don't want her barking.
Yes.
What can I say about Carmelita? As you can see, our relationship is complicated, and I just succeeded in upgrading it to hazardous. I certainly wasn't expecting her to crash the party. She'd been so busy with her latest case, I never thought she'd have her eye on me. In fact, I'd kind of been counting on it. But then, I should have known better than to underestimate Inspector Carmelita Fox. As much as she liked having fun, Carmelita was serious about her police work. And now, I had a lot of explaining to do. But the plan was in motion, and there was no stopping now. Even though I was thinking I'd need the time machine just to patch things up with Carmelita. Before the heist, we recruited our disco-loving, scuba-diving friend, Dimitri Lestow, to look after the thieves' raccoons. Because it was irreplaceable and the only guide we had, it was far too risky to take the book through time with us. Bentley had even invented a communication device to allow us to contact Dimitri no matter where or when we traveled. It was a perfect situation, since it allowed him to update us on any changes to the book while limiting our exposure to his fashion critiques. Everything was happening so fast. The past few days were just a blur. But as we howled through the time vortex, I realized we were in for a very long trip. Cooper, Master Ninja, and Master Chef. According to the Cooper clan history, Ryuichi Cooper was actually the inventor of sushi. After creating this delectable dish, he opened a sushi restaurant, which, while very prosperous, also provided the perfect cover for a ninja. When we got to Japan, it was obvious something was very wrong. What should have been a peaceful village was more like a heavily patrolled military base. We located Ryuichi's sushi restaurant, only to find it shut down and under guard. Things got worse when Bentley discovered that Ryuichi was locked up in a new high-security jail, allegedly for serving bad sushi to the shogun. It all sounded like a pretty tough piece of fish to swallow. We needed to get to the bottom of the situation, and the first order of business was getting Ryuichi out of prison.
Thank you.
shot of this guy's ugly mug for Bentley. Oh, he should be crawling around a tropical jungle somewhere.
Shut your mouth up now!
Database security, Murray's pants.
Whatever, Sly. This is no laughing matter. I've checked, and there really is no way in except for the front entrance. I think there's only one option.
The doorbell.
Very funny. Now, you're going to need a disguise. Get yourself a suit of armor from those guards. That's our way in.
Roger that. Just call me Samurai Sly. Thank you.
Luigi Cooper. Are you okay?
You guys all seem to make very poor jokes.
Come on, I'm not one of those bozos. I'm gonna bust you out. The name's Sly.
I see, a fellow ninja. Very good. You will need to make your way to the Dragon Bridge to reach this cage. Hurry up.
Okay, I'll be there soon. Just stay put.
Very funny.
it. Rescuing Ryuichi, we returned to the hideout. Unfortunately, there wasn't much time for family reunions. We needed to figure out what was going on, and fast. Ryuichi confirmed that the source of the trouble was the tiger we had tracked in the village, someone calling himself El Jefe. After some more database digging, Bentley was able to uncover his Interpol file. El Jefe had an impressive record. Over the years, he had taken over dozens of small countries around the globe, usually for the highest bidder. He was a ruthless mercenary and military strategist of the highest order. In fact, he once boasted that he could overthrow a country commanding only 3 blind mice, armed with plastic spoons. According to his file, this guy had mysteriously vanished a while back, just as the authorities were closing in. Well, we had found him, and we needed to take him down. like we were in for a tough battle. So, we decided to start with Ryoichi's Sushi Chef.
You shut up!
Okay, Ryoichi, I guess it'll be to tell you about your old place.
Don't worry, Murray. We'll be fishing in no time.
With the miniature microphone I installed, it should be a snap to follow El Jefe and see what he's up to. Looks like he's headed for the prison. Time to get rolling.
This magnificent prison pales when compared to my new statue fortress.
New statue fortress? That must be where he's hiding out all the time.
Nobody would guess the Ballast Gate switch is actually under the bridge.
You're messing with the wrong turtle, buddy.
Are invincible as long as that lazy god doesn't get distracted by sushi.
Very interesting. I think we can probably help that guard out.
Even if those fools get to the dragon gates, they'll never figure out the switches are inside the dragon mouths. So I can deliver the package to the boss.
Package? Boss? We need to figure out what's going on with that palace.
Konnichiwa, Hefe-san!
Greetings, Madam Geisha.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ryuichi's special sushi rolls, the guards are out for the count. Sly, you'll need to gain access to the switches in their mouths. Next, we'll need to open the palace sword gate. However, the bridge is crawling with guards, so we'll need to create a diversion. Murray, you, Sly, and myself will need to distract the guards. Once they're occupied, Ryuichi can make his way under the bridge to the switch and open the gate. Once we get that gate open, there's nothing stopping us from taking the palace and putting El Jefe in his place. Viva la Revolucion!
Okay, Sly. Use those rules.
looks like a real pigeon magnet.
I hope you can fly like a pigeon, Cooper. Otherwise, you'll never catch me.
We'll see about that. Big enough to contain your overinflated ego.
Take a nice long look. I want you to remember the one who crushed you.
Looks to me like you've got nowhere left to run, El Jefe. Ready to face me now?
Sticking up for the family, eh, Cooper? Too bad you'll never see any of them again.
Deliciously rich coffee with coffee made at home. Coffee's perfect made. Coffee made. Fancy Beast. Chef inspired. Cat adored.
MSRP on our most popular 2024 Jeep Grand Cherokee models. Visit Jeep.com for details.
I wait tables. Well, last week, I built a field hospital. I stopped 1,000 attackers.
Had a natural disaster.
Well, I go to school full-time while I work full-time.
Greater the challenge, the stronger we become.
Thank you.
face and delivered to the cops. But it was a hollow victory. I failed to get back Ryuichi's cane, and we still had no idea who was really behind this whole thing. One thing was for sure, it was somebody powerful enough to have his own private army. We contacted Dimitri for an update on the Thievius Raccoonus, and it looked like Tennessee Kid Cooper needed our help next. That meant we needed to travel back to the 1880s. Luckily, one of the goons that took Ryuichi's cane had dropped what looked like an old sheriff's badge. Bentley had been trying to figure out where it might be from, but now it all made sense. After sampling the badge, Bentley was able to calibrate the time machine. As we prepared to make the jump back to the Old West, I found myself wondering how Carmelita was doing. Ancestor, Tennessee Kid Cooper, a legendary outlaw whose bank robberies were some of the most daring in Cooper lore. When we arrived, it took some time to locate him, but we eventually found him in prison. His arrest was the handiwork of the local sheriff, who had celebrated by posting his own picture all over town. Talk about an ego. We needed to bust Tennessee out of jail. But after some furious calculations, Bentley determined that the best way to do that was from the inside. For the first time in my career, I was going to have to let the law catch me. This could be a real challenge. Arrested? I trust you, Bentley, but I'm not sure about getting locked up in this town.
Sorry, Sly. It's the only way we're gonna reach Tennessee in time. There's just one problem. They're holding Kid Cooper in the maximum security wing. To get yourself thrown in there, you're gonna have to gain outlaw status. So you need to make sure you build a rep before they catch you. Otherwise, they'll throw you in with the common criminals.
You mean like jaywalkers and litter bugs? Not gonna happen.
Well, around these parts, it's probably more like goat thieves and tobacco spinners. But you get the point. For starters, why don't you try defacing all those posters of the sheriff around town? That ought to put a fur under his saddle. Get it? Because we're in the Old West? Well, anyway, I'll just let you get started.
Thank you.
just damaged his vision staring at this guy.
I like it, Sly.
Let's hope so. I call it counterfeit courage.
Particular Cuban variety, which has to be shipped in specially.
must have ticked old Toothpick off pretty good. I like that. You got a name?
It's Sly. Sly Cooper.
Now, son, you should know I don't take kindly to folks funning on my family name.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I swear, I'm not joking. I can explain.
Talk ain't worth speak, boy. Only one way to prove you're a Cooper. Bust us out of here.
Right. My friend Bentley's working on that. I hope.
I press the square button to swing that ball. He'll smash through that wall like it's... Right, you need to make your way to the bottom of the tower. Right, here's your chance. Use the ball to break down that door and bust Tennessee out.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bentley.
Son, who is it you keep talking to?
I have a thing in my ear that lets me talk to my friend. And now he's telling me you need to carry some of that TNT so we can blow the gate.
Sure. I got voices in my head telling me to blow things up, too. They've been right so far. Let's get to it. This one out.
Thank you.
somehow, we had managed to survive and make it back to the hideout. Once there, Tennessee gave us the lowdown, how he'd been planning the bank heist that should have gone down in Cooper lore as his masterpiece, only to have a mysterious new sheriff arrest him before he even reached the bank. Curiously, the robbery still occurred, and all the bank's gold was stolen. Tennessee was charged, even though he was already in prison, and the gold was never recovered. Of course, he had a strong suspicion it was Sheriff Toothpick himself who had stolen the gold and framed him. And after a little research, there was no doubt he was right. Bentley was able to uncover plenty of information about the sheriff. Although he changed his appearance somewhat, Toothpick was a two-bit gangster from present-day Eastern Europe. According to his file, he'd grown up loving two things, gold and cowboy movies. He eventually specialized in gold robberies, and for a while had masterminded some of the largest scores around the world. Then he abruptly vanished. The word was he had always thought of himself as a gunslinger, and it looked like he had found a way to make that a reality. The guy was a real loose cannon. We'd have to watch our backs if we were going to steal back the missing gold and restore Tennessee Kid Cooper's reputation as the greatest outlaw of the Old West.
Sombrero.
get some rest, baby. Get some rest. Leave the door unlocked there while I check on you. Go to sleep.
You will go to sleep.